almost didn't make it, I almost didn't last. Why does the week go by so slow, the weekend so fast? But luckily the day's come to take my cares away. It's not Sunday, Monday, or Thursday, that's right, it's Friday, Friday. Tonight I'll party with my friends. Friday, Friday. Today I know the weekend. So I'll get out of bed and be to work on time. I'll give this day to the company, the next 2 days of mine. Through my day's over and the final work hour's passed, I'll go home, have a shot of Cuervo to the boss who can kiss my Friday, Friday. Tonight I'll party with my friends. Friday, Friday. Today I know the weekend. Friday, Friday.
Yeah! It's Friday, bitches. Enjoy yourselves. Cloudy, foggy.
Oh my gosh. It is so foggy in Eau Claire. It is so foggy in La Crosse. It is so foggy.
Yeah, lights on. I know it gets bright early, but keep your headlights on as you're heading to work this morning so people can see you. As you're driving through the fog, whether you're in
Chippewa
La Crosse
Falls,
or Osseo or Eau Claire.
Arcadia.
Or wherever you're at. Yeah, especially in those coolies, man.
Black River Falls. Ooh. Yeah, oof.
I just rode through there the other day. I'm sure there's spots where it's really dicey.
Although, I mean, get through this morning and be very careful. Please, please, please.
Yeah. But looks later, like sun later on. Highs in the low 70s.
72 should be a great Friday.
Lots to get to this morning. Doc will join us to talk racing. Three ways with Shaw. Bad news, happy music. Friday edition, always fun. Get to our daily check-ins. Let you know what's on TV this weekend and in theaters. I'm going to be a little too busy to do any of that. I got two concerts this weekend.
Me too. No, I don't have two concerts. I have prom. There's a big prom. And so prom photos and prom
is everything good? The shoes, the flowers, the dress, everything's all sorted out?
That could be a last minute panic. You can never tell with those things. So that's happening. And Junie's big surgery today. Big girl surgery.
Oh yeah, getting fixed, huh?
Yes.
All right. Cone of shame or
probably they do the
donut thing now, yeah. All right.
Yeah. That's this morning though, so
what time is that at?
Big day. Big day.
Is that an overnight or just to pick her up? Really? All right. All right, lots to get to. If you want to reach out and talk to us, visit rockmornings.com for all of our contact information. We've got some Motionless and White coming up, and Scott Robert Shaw in the newsroom next.
More of your Rock Mornings coming up in just a bit.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw. You'll be happy to know I didn't race anybody yesterday. I went straight home, took a nap, and then got up in the afternoon, did some stuff around the house, worked on the computer, watched a movie, and then went to bed. So
full day.
Yeah. Everybody's safe. I did not race anyone in a minivan. We got fog here in downtown La Crosse and also up in Eau Claire. It looks like it's pretty thick based on the cameras that we're looking at from the Eau Claire area, Shaw. So obviously keep your headlights on as you're headed to work this morning. Let people know you're out there. Be on the lookout for, you know, pedestrians and people on bikes and all that crap.
Dense fog advisory, by the way, Buffalo, Houston, Trempealeau, Winona counties. Visibility 1/4 mile in dense fog or less. Yeah. So you
advisory until 8 o'clock this morning.
Yeah, be careful.
It's getting a little thick right now.
Well, and 72 and sunny later on, so it should be pretty nice afterwards, but it'll take a while for this to burn off. What's the latest, Shaw?
Well, President Joe Biden has defended the right to free speech, but says order must prevail on college campuses where pro-Palestinian protests are happening. The president says protests have not prompted him to rethink his Middle East policies, and he opposes sending in the National Guard. Biden's comments broke days of silence as police cracked down on encampments that were erected to show solidarity with Gaza. Student protesters have reached a boiling point as administrators turned to police to clear encampments. Some 34 arrests were made earlier this week on the UW-Madison campus. Today, a rally in support of Palestinians is planned on the UW-La Crosse campus. That is scheduled for 2 o'clock this afternoon at the campus clock tower. Campus protesters want the U.S. to cut off any support for Israel. The message of Save Social Security is being spread throughout Wisconsin. An informational picket took place yesterday outside the Social Security office in downtown La Crosse. Demonstrators are calling on Washington to fully fund the agency's budget and protect entitlements. The group included Jessica LaPointe, the president of a union council for Social Security workers in Wisconsin. She says cuts in funding for the Bureau can lead to delays in citizens getting their government benefits.
Baby boomers are retiring at a rate of $12,000 a week.
Oh,
and
man.
Congress has not met that demand. In fact, they have slashed Social Security's operating budget by more than 20% over the last decade.
Similar picketing has been done in other cities around the state since late March.
I want to be one of those 12,000.
12,000 retirees, yeah. The La Crosse Transit Utility is in the market for more buses. The city's finance committee has authorized the purchase of 5 new diesel buses for the MTU.
Wait a minute.
Yes.
I thought we were going green and saving the carbon and all that crap. I thought we were eco-friendly and all this stuff.
We do have some electric buses.
We're getting more diesel?
Yes. Transit Director Adam Lorenz says the average useful life of a city bus is 12 years, and 9 of the buses in the La Crosse fleet have passed that 12-year mark. Now, the MTU also has 2 electric buses, but Lorenz says the wait for a new electric vehicle can take several months.
So let's just get them diesels.
Yeah. Can't wait any longer, right?
All right.
And the farmers market season is about to begin in La Crosse. Vendors traditionally sell their items at Cameron Park downtown on Friday nights from May through October, usually starting around 4 p.m. for the second straight season. There will not be a market in the park on Saturday mornings because of reduced turnout for Saturday's farmers markets in recent years.
Yeah, it looks like Eau Claire's farmers market kicks off tomorrow as well. This weekend is the big weekend.
It is
May
that time
now.
Of year.
It's going to be that. Well, people are talking about getting baskets too, Shaw. It's officially that time of year, so...
Mm-hmm.
I know Gene was mentioning that. Are you still doing that this weekend?
Well, I was going to yesterday, and I was tomorrow. I was super excited about it because I haven't been to any of the local Amish farm greenhouses ever, and I know a lot of people do that. And I thought it sounded super fun, and I have a few hours before prom in the afternoon. I was like, I'll take care. But then I forgot that my dog's having surgery, and we have to pick her up tomorrow morning, and probably leaving her home alone while we go.
Not a good idea,
so that's off the table for this weekend.
All right. Well, you may be left out in the cold then.
But a great day for farmers markets today, anyway.
For sure.
And looks like, is tomorrow still rain in the morning?
Before 3 p.m., they're saying.
I'm keeping a close eye on the forecast for tomorrow, Shaw, because we obviously have a big outdoor show tomorrow night. Copeland Park and Event Center, See Their Skillet, Fuel 10 Years, and Keith Wallen of Breaking Benjamin. And according to every forecast that I look at, whether it's National Weather Service or something a little more local, it seems like it's going to rain in the morning, almost a guaranteed rain, somewhere around 65% in the morning tomorrow. But then by about 4 o'clock in the afternoon, it starts to dry up.
Yeah, that's what I'm seeing, too.
And then right around 5, between 5 and 11, it looks like we'll be just cloudy with no rain. So it might get wet during the day. And the field may be wet, but I think we'll be dry during the show because the doors are at like 4 for early entry, 4:30 for the GA, 5:15 is when the music starts. Mm-hmm. And again, those grandstand GA tickets are sold out along with the pit passes and the early entry passes. So the only thing that's left is the on-field GA. We should be good. We should be dry during the show at least. Obviously, it's going to cool off too, so hoodie weather. Remember that? Don't go down there in T-shirt and Daisy Dukes.
During the day, right?
It's not going to be like super duper warm.
Yeah, low of 41. That's overnight on Saturday night. So it's not going to be that chilly by 7 o'clock at night, but by morning it will.
Yeah, tapering off in the early afternoon hours, it sounds like, for the rain. So that's okay.
Bro, me in a hoodie and shorts with a beer in my hand and a band on stage that I love. Could it get any better?
Little chill in there, enough to be in your favorite hoodie.
I think I might have a new hoodie for tomorrow.
Like,
can I retire that old one?
Well, so I've got the gray one, and I like it, but I wanted to get a black one, and I had a black one, and I don't know where the hell it went. I misplaced it. And then I had the new one with the new logo we had our friend Jake design for us.
Yeah.
The tattoo logo.
Mm-hmm.
While I was trying to stretch out the neck because it was a little too tight, and I ended up pulling too hard, and I ripped it, and now it's like torn halfway down here, and I don't like it because it's all, you know, I'm very particular about my hoodies, much like everything else. I'm very particular.
I was just going to say, just your hoodies?
Well, the problem is, that's one thing I'm very particular about. But so I'm this afternoon.
You're in the market for one?
This afternoon, I may go. We have a friend, in the area that makes T-shirts and hoodies and stuff like that. And I think she's got a plethora of hoodies I can go try on and check out and see which one I like. Because that's the problem. You know, you get this hoodie that's already pre-printed at a brewery or at a, you know, ball game or whatever. And you're like, yeah, I'll get that one. And then you put it on, you wear it, and you're like, I didn't really like this one.
Can't get your head through it?
Well, not that. It's just they all fit differently. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. They just all have some of them, the cuffs are too big or they're too tight or they don't stay rolled up when you pull them up like this. Some of them don't.
Pull your arms.
I don't have that problem too often because I got stubby arms and legs. But, you know, and then some of them, they don't, they're not long enough. They're too short. And, yeah, and some of them are too big. And the next two, it's just.
Why don't you get a merch one tomorrow night?
Well, I'll probably buy one as well. But I'm not going to just, like, wear that at the show, you know. Anyways, I could go on for days talking about my hoodies. It's either hoodies or work shirts now. That's kind of my, that's about it for me when I buy clothing.
And it's the work shirt for dress-up occasions, is that?
Oh, that's, yeah, that's
a nice. When you need to take it to a next level.
Yep, when
he's
I'm going
button up.
Yeah.
It says Carhartt.
If there's more than one fork on the table when I sit down, then it's probably work shirt type restaurant. Yeah. Smashing Pumpkins coming up after Motionless and White.
Rock Mornings. On air. Online. On the app.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. That is the Smashing Pumpkins, Bullet with Butterfly Wings. Starting to lighten up a little bit, at least here in downtown La Crosse. But dense fog advisory till 8 o'clock, I believe.
Yeah, for a number of counties with visibility under a quarter of a mile. So be careful while you're out this morning. You know, watch for deer, watch for cars, people, headlights, taillights, all of that stuff.
Keep your headlights on.
But this afternoon should be nice. We're looking at 70s throughout Eau Claire, Chippewa Falls, down the valley, all the way down Osseo, down to La Crosse, and Holman, Arcadia. Should be sunshine and low 70s.
Speaking of the fog, got a text from Chris. Said, hey, guys, Chris from Meadow Valley Log Homes. Wife and I are camping up in Fountain City at the racetrack for the World of Outlaws late model weekend, doing the 100-mile rummage thing.
Yeah, somewhere, a bunch of my friends are doing that.
Said, it's bad foggy here. Can't see bleep.
Yeah.
TGIF, baby. Do you get to TGIF when you're already camping? When you're already, like, not working? Do you get to TGIF?
I think so. You can't own TGIF. Just
while Chris, enjoy your weekend and the rummage sale.
I hope you find some good things. I was just talking about
treasures.
So that thing goes all the way up the river. 100 miles.
Treasures.
All the way to Wabasha, I guess.
Treasures.
Past even.
100-mile rummage sale. Enjoy it. Have fun. Be safe. Thanks for the text. If you want to get in touch with us, visit rockmornings.com. The Brewers were off yesterday. They started a three-game series against the Cubs in Chicago today. 1:20 first pitch, so a couple of afternoon games against the Cubbies. In the NBA last night, the Pacers eliminating the Bucks thanks to a 120-98 win. The Bucks kind of kept it close there in the first half, but then Indy, of course, took control in the second half. Indiana moves on to face Philly in the next round. Philly eliminated the Knicks last night with a 118-115 win. Patrick Beverley appeared to engage in a heated altercation with a fan in the closing minutes of the Bucks' season-ending loss to the Pacers last night. Beverley checked out of the game for good with about 2.5 minutes to go as he stood near the Bucks' bench. TNT broadcast capturing Pat Bev calling for a basketball from a nearby fan. Not quite sure if the fan like brought the ball in or bought it at the pro shop or what the sitch was there. It looked like maybe the fan wanted him to autograph it or something. It was a Pacers fan. He's wearing Pacers gear right behind the Bucks bench. And as he kind of lobs it over, Pat grabs it right away and just chucks it right back at the guy. Yeah, it looked like he intended to do that, by the way. We'll see if the NBA comes down on him at all. NBA tonight, Cleveland at Orlando, 6 o'clock on ESPN, Game 6 of that series. Cavs are up 3-2. The Clippers are at the Mavericks at 8:30 on ESPN for Game 6 of that series. Dallas up 3-2. NHL last night, Toronto Maple Leafs beat the Bruins 2-1. That series now tied up at 3 apiece, and a decisive Game 7 comes up tomorrow night. In the NHL tonight, Vancouver is at Nashville, 6 o'clock on TNT, Game 6 of that series. Canucks are up 3-2. Dallas at Vegas at 9 p.m. on TNT for Game 6. Stars are up 3-2. This weekend, you got the Kentucky Derby Saturday.
Heck yeah.
TV coverage starts at 1:30 on NBC and Peacock and runs until about 6:30. The race is obviously only a couple of minutes long.
Yeah. I have to get to the location where I'm watching that after photos for prom because if you don't get there and get your cocktail, all of a sudden you're like, oh, it's over.
Yeah. A lot of places doing Kentucky Derby thing. I misspoke. I don't know what the hell I wrote down, but Philly got eliminated by the Knicks last night.
Okay.
The Knicks won and are moving on. So yeah. I don't misspoke. Also this weekend, Tom Brady roast, Sunday night, Netflix, 7 p.m. live on Netflix. Tom Brady, the greatest roast of all time.
Can you stand it?
I'm very excited. Belichick, man. See what his comedy chops are. He's trying to rehab his image. What's going on with Pat McAfee?
Is he trying to get it like a...
Well, he wants to get another job, and I think people are sick of his crap. I mean, it got away with it in New England because he won all the Super Bowls, and they let him kind of, you know, have carte blanche.
He wants to be a commentator?
No, he wants to get back into coaching. The problem is that nobody wants him as a coach because he's kind of a pain in the ass. And he doesn't associate well with players. Look, it's a different league, dude. These 25, 20-year-old kids that are coming out of college, they don't want to
deal with you.
They don't want to deal with you, bro. they want someone who's on social media and is emotional about them and cares about them and all that stuff.
Maybe not him.
Yeah.
So he's trying to
He's trying to seem like, you know, the happy granddad, I guess. I don't know. I mean, he went on College Game Day and everybody loved that appearance when he was with Lee Corso and all those guys and he had the helmet and everything. And
so it's
and then he gets fired. And now he goes on with Pat McAfee during the draft. And, you know, I don't know if he did anything other than get his name out there and get in front of a different audience, possibly.
So the Tom Brady roast drinking game.
Oh, geez.
So you got to take a drink if anyone brings up deflated balls.
Oh, man. You're going to get drunk in the first 10 minutes.
If a member of the 80s for Brady's cast makes an appearance.
God, I forgot about that crap. Stupid Lily Tomlin movie.
Take a drink on Sunday night. This is Sunday night.
Sunday night, 7 o'clock, Netflix.
If anyone makes a joke about the Jets, that's going to happen, right? You're going to have cocktails for that. No, the Jets?
I don't know.
Brady Belichick.
Brady had more of a thing with Peyton Manning. You know what I mean? The Colts. Ben Roethlisberger. You know, the Ravens.
So this is
the Jets were never. I mean, they're a doormat. The Patriots beat them every single time. I mean, they never. Other than the couple of years that Rex Ryan was there, the Jets were always just sort of a footnote.
This athlete-heavy roast will take place on Sunday Night Live. Take a drink if the Brady Belichick breakup is mentioned. That's going to happen.
Oh yeah.
The time when Brady miscounted four downs in 2020 and then got memed. If that comes up, apparently.
That's very specific. I think it's going to be more general topics, you know, the deflate gates.
Take two drinks if Eli Manning shows up.
Oh, he's going to be there. Of course he is. He's the only guy to beat, well, not the only guy, but he beat him twice in the Super Bowl. Yeah. All right. Shaw coming up in just a bit. Also some Asking Alexandria next.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw.
You've been doing your daily action, putting lots of overtime. You need some time off satisfaction. Just think how tough it's been. You've been putting out all that labor. If you use your wit, you can get out quick and do yourself a favor. Friday in effect, and you're pretty beat, I bet. It's been one tough week, you've hit your peak, and you've earned your paycheck. But now this week is over, and it's a little fun you're seeking. Your grin is wide, and I know why. Look out, here come the weekend. You know what I'm saying?
Weekend?
That weekend's gonna be a monster, y'all.
Big weekend for me, Shaw.
Big show tomorrow night.
Big show tonight.
Tonight, rather.
Flo Rida.
Oh, that's right.
It's at the Lacrosse Center, and I'm going.
Nice.
And then big show tomorrow, of course, after the rain. It looks like it'll end in the afternoon, Shaw, and clear up, and then it should be okay. Today should be great once we get through this fog.
Mm-hmm. Fog's lifting, too, so.
And then looks like it'll be sunny again on Sunday with a high right around 70. Probably going to spend a lot of Sunday outdoors after being
outside. Well, I guess you're outside for the concert.
Well, yeah, but it's going to be, you know. Mm-hmm. Nice on Sunday. Netflix today, the Pop-Tart movie, Unfrosted. Huh. Written, directed, and starring Jerry Seinfeld.
It's about the history of Pop-Tarts, right?
It's not necessarily true. It's based on a true story.
Okay.
One of those things. They take some liberties.
Watch the trailer. It'll help a lot.
Okay. Jerry Seinfeld stars in the Unfrosted movie, Pop-Tarts movie, about an ambitious employee trying to help Kellogg's beat a rival cereal company to win the race to create a breakfast pastry back in the 1960s. Jim Gaffigan plays his boss. Amy Schumer is the head of Post Cereal. Melissa McCarthy is a NASA scientist who joins the Kellogg's team and helps develop the Pop-Tart. Yeah, it's, I don't know. I think I might
give it a try.
Kind of based on reality. Over on Peacock today, the streaming premiere of The American Society of Magical Negroes, a romantic comedy starring Justice Smith as a guy who is recruited by David Alan Greer to join a society dedicated to protecting black people by magically making the lives of white people easier.
Okay.
I don't think I've even heard of this.
No, me either. Strange premise.
Streaming on Peacock today, by the way. Tonight on ABC, the 15th season finale of Shark Tank. Over on Netflix tonight, the series premiere of John Mulaney Presents Everybody's in L.A.
Mm-hmm.
Don't know exactly what that's about. Saturday, tomorrow on Disney Plus, of course, May the 4th, Shaw.
Mm-hmm.
So why not get some new Star Wars content?
Ooh,
Star Wars, Tales of the Empire, tomorrow on Disney Plus. Also tomorrow on Netflix, the stand-up special Cat Williams, Woke Folk.
I'm in between a pimp and a hard place. Donna, man down, 11:30, pimp in distress.
Cat Williams, Woke Folk, tomorrow on Netflix. Tomorrow night on SNL, Dua Lipa is the hostess and also the musical guest. Which one is she? Which one's Dua Lipa?
Mm-hmm.
And they play her on Z.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'll take your word for it. American Idol on ABC on Sunday night. It's Adele night, so they're singing Adele tunes. Hello. Think somebody will do the James Bond one?
Mm, sure, the theme song.
Skyfall, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's a pretty big, dramatic song.
It is.
And then, of course, Sunday night on Netflix, we were just talking about it a few minutes ago, the roast of Tom Brady.
Let's go,
Shaw. Let's go. Most of the late night shows tonight are in repeats. New in theaters this weekend, The Fall Guy, Ryan Gosling.
Hey, Grum, happy Thanksgiving. I'm thankful for your yams and sweet potato pie.
Hey, girl. PG-13, Ryan Gosling, Hollywood stuntman, flies to Australia to work on a movie directed by his ex-girlfriend, played by Emily Blunt.
Mm-hmm.
When he gets there, he finds out the producer lied, the star has gone missing, and they want him to track down the star of the film. Winston Duke plays Ryan Gosling's best friend in the movie. Aaron Taylor Johnson is the missing movie star. It's loosely based on the 1980s TV series that starred Lee Majors as a stuntman, and he even gets a post-scene or a post-credit scene. He pops up there, okay. So stick around afterwards. Also in theaters this weekend, Tarot, rated PG-13, supernatural horror movie about a group of friends who find a creepy deck of cards in the basement of a mansion.
Let's play!
And what do? They start messing around.
Uh-huh.
Again, no one in movies has ever seen a movie before. What happens when you go into the basement and you find something creepy? Leave it there. Don't touch it. Don't look at it. Leave quickly. Let's hide behind the wall of running chainsaws. Also, new music this weekend. Better Than Ezra. I've got a new song out, or a new album out. It's called Super Magic. It's their 9th album. These guys, yeah. Better Than Ezra Shaw.
Kind of a fun band.
Big hit here back in the 90s.
Good.
No?
Mm-hmm.
Also, POD has a new album out called Veritas. It's their 11th album. So, there you go. That's what's on the boob tube this weekend and in theaters and spinning on your CD player. What else is happening?
A Pennsylvania nurse who administered lethal or potentially lethal doses of insulin to numerous patients has pleaded guilty to 3 counts of murder and other charges and has been sentenced to life in prison. 41-year-old Heather Presti was given 3 consecutive life sentences and another consecutive term of 380 to 760 years behind bars in a hearing yesterday. Prosecutors say she played a role in the deaths of at least 17 patients who lived in 5 health facilities in 4 different counties between 2020 and 2023. Co-workers often questioned Presti's conduct and said she frequently showed disdain for her patients and made derogatory comments about them. A motorcycle rider from La Crosse died in a collision with a car in Houston County earlier this week. The Minnesota State Patrol now says 23-year-old Cameron Sokolik of La Crosse collided with an oncoming Ford Fusion on Highway 26 near Brownsville shortly before 9 o'clock Wednesday night. Sokolik was killed in that crash. The car was driven by a Waukon, Iowa woman, Kathleen Grangard. She was not hurt. Social Security in danger is a warning coming from government workers who were worried that cuts by Congress could prevent many Americans from getting their benefit payments on time. Government employees stood outside the La Crosse Social Security office yesterday to protest the proposed federal reductions. Representing a government workers' council in Wisconsin, Jessica LaPointe of Madison said cuts in funding for the Social Security system can have harmful effects on people waiting for their checks.
It can take up to 4 months or more to get an appointment to file for retirement benefits.
it can take up to 8 months to get an initial disability decision on an application, and it can take up to 2.5 years to get a decision through the hearing level.
LaPointe says thousands of Americans each year die while waiting for their delayed Social Security checks, and millions of others are going bankrupt. She says paying the Bureau's workers properly can reduce delays for customers. Veterans from the La Crosse area will take two more trips to Washington this year to see national monuments. The first local Freedom Honor flight for 2024 happens tomorrow, with a second scheduled for late September. More than 600 veterans are on the waiting list for the one-day trips. The La Crosse Freedom Flight program began in 2008.
Yeah, what a cool...
That is awesome.
...cool thing, and obviously the... Not to be the... The negative guy, but, you know, the time is running out for those people.
For sure.
In terms of how many years they've got left to be able to go and experience that. You hope that they can all eventually get there. Mm-hmm. Check it out.
By the way, founded here, but serving 30 counties in 3 states. If you have a veteran or know a veteran or you're, you know, in your family that would like to do this, that it is open to anyone. You can sign up online. It is
fully free.
Fully funded fully by funded. Donations, yep. Including the volunteer
awesome.
That goes with the veteran for the day and helps assist. And there's another one in September, by the way. So the 2 each year, it sounds like, and open throughout the state of Wisconsin, into Minnesota and Iowa as well. So you can find out more if you go to freedomhonorflight.org.
Thank you, Sean. Mm-hmm. We'll talk to you again in just a bit. Got a text from Ann. Sent in a picture of her pooches. She said, "Hey, Brian and Gene, these pups and I would like to hear some Hailstorm Freak Like Me. Happy Friday." Aw, puppies. That's a good way to get your song played. Include a picture of your dogs. Especially the old guy.
Yeah.
You gotta see his face.
Rock Mornings. Only on 95.7 The Rock.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw. That has requested Hailstorm for Ann, who said, "Hi, Brian and Gene, these pups and I would like to hear some Hailstorm Freak Like Me. Happy Friday." A couple of poodles and almost like a sheepdog. Old guy. Got that text from Chris. Fountain City Racetrack for the World of Outlaws Late Model Weekend. Also doing the 100-mile rummage sale thing.
Very foggy this
morning.
Said
it's very foggy, bad foggy. It's also foggy here and foggy in Eau Claire and foggy everywhere. Dense fog advisory for another hour, so
yes.
Keep those headlights on.
Mm-hmm.
Got a text from Chad, wants to hear some Slayer, Seasons in the Abyss. I'll see what I can do about that. Tom wanted to hear some Rammstein, Du Hast. See what I can do about that as well. If you want to get in touch with us, visit rockmornings.com. You can listen to the program live on the website. You can check out our daily podcast, find all of our contact information there as well.
Trying to figure out how to bet on the Derby tomorrow. I know nothing about gambling on horses. And so I'm trying to figure out, I mean, I know you can do like just who's going to win, but you can also do like picking who's going to show and place.
Are you trying to do it online or through an app?
I'm trying to do it online, but I don't know what I'm doing. I literally don't know what I'm doing. So this is fun.
This will be fun.
Yeah.
Are you asking for help or are you just...
No, I just began my gambling journey here, okay? So give me a little bit more time. But I have a friend who gambles on this every year and has won, like, wins every year.
Then talk to them. His mother was a mutter. He loves the mud. His father was a mutter. His mother was a mother. Santeria from Sublime coming up in just a bit.
Rock Mornings, Monday to Friday, 6 to 9.
Santeria from Sublime, Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. The fog intensifying, even thicker than it was 5 minutes ago. Please keep your headlights on as you're headed to work. I know we try to remind people of that all the time. I don't know how effective it is, but...
Yeah, it looks like it's getting better in Eau Claire, in La Crosse. Very much thicker in downtown La Crosse, I can tell you that right now. And we have those dense fog advisories in the area, Buffalo, Houston, Jackson, Trempealeau, Winona counties until 8 o'clock this morning. It will eventually burn off, and it looks like a beautiful Friday for all intents and purposes with low 70s and lots of sunshine.
Been to a chiropractor recently?
Not recently.
No? Are you a chiropractic person?
I have been off and on. Not like... On a regular...
Because there's people that swear by it, right?
Coworkers here that go all the time.
Migraine people,
mm-hmm.
right? Say that...
It gives them relief, yes. My mom goes regularly.
I, I, I've been a couple of times. I'm not trying to diss the chiropractic industry. I'm just saying I never really felt all that. I'd rather get a massage. Have you seen the giraffe chiropractor?
No.
It's viral, obviously. Everybody's loving it. Because he's out, like, on a balcony. And the giraffe, obviously, super long neck. And he's up there, and it looks like he's just kind of petting him. And then all of a sudden, he gives it. And it apparently works really well. And people are enamored with this guy on the internets.
That's a specific job, isn't it?
Yeah. So he's in Oklahoma, and he's in the news because he specializes in working with animals. Done adjustments for dogs, chickens, and now a giraffe all over the gram.
Being able to work on a giraffe is a chiropractor's dream. I mean, it's the largest neck in the world.
His jaw was not moving to the left.
Their hair is pokey and their tongues are really slimy. Oh, it's like a short-haired cactus. And they're a lot more appreciative, I think, than some of my human patients.
Dr. Joren Whitley, I think is how you pronounce his name. It's J-O-R-E-N, and you want to find him on Instagram. He's there, but yeah, he's kind of like, you know, they got those horns, right, that kind of stick out, those two little bumps, and he's kind of grabbing those things and pushing them down and working on the neck itself up by the head, and then he kind of does the giraffes, you know, cool with him and giving him a little sniff and a little face nuzzle.
And then he comes in and does
Then he does the whole, you know, rubs him down and scratches him, and then he does the hug thing, and that's when he gets a real pop in there. But he says, while very friendly, this giraffe could become defensive and use his whatever the hell, the ossicones, against me at any moment. That's why I take my adjustments slowly and delicately. But yeah, everybody in love with this guy. Cracking the neck of a giraffe.
We were at a zoo, I think in Omaha once, and we were on a elevated balcony thing, and we got to
feed them and
come in for pet, and the big long tongues. But you're up close and personal to their faces. It was so cool. It was so cool.
Text from Jim. Says, happy Friday. No chiropractor for me. Went once and I hurt more, but some people swear by it.
Yeah. My mom does.
Yeah, it's, you know, not for everybody, but some people go all the time. Any luck with your betting?
No.
Okay.
I mean, I'm on a website called How to Bet on the Kentucky Derby, so...
Betting on the Kentucky Derby for dummies?
Yeah, basically. Okay. But these, I didn't even recognize half of these names are crazy.
Do you have a horse that you think is your favorite?
Well, I just read some experts and what horses they're picking to win. But I feel like I'm more of a long odds kind of gal, right? If I'm going to
That's how you make the big money.
Well, and that's where it could be fun.
If you're betting the favorite and they're in the mix the entire race, that's still a lot of fun. It's the fastest 2 minutes in sports. So it doesn't really matter. I mean, if you can't get up for that, then I don't know what the hell's going to work for you. This is your first go-around with gambling.
Yes.
I don't think it matters. I mean...
Right. That's what I was thinking. I'll put some on, you know, this, a little bit on that, and see how it goes. But I'm literally gambling for dummies right now.
How much do you have a budget?
About, I don't know, $50 total.
Whoa.
I know, right?
Jeez.
20 on this, 10 on that.
Breaking the bank over here. Are you doing any prop bets or are you just strict odds? Odds on to win.
I don't know yet. I don't know. I don't know. I'm also going to drink a mint julep, by the way, which are not that great and not my favorite.
I've never had one.
I had one last year and I went in Rome and I was doing the whole Kentucky Derby
thing. The hat? What was the hat?
I had the hat.
What was the hat?
The whole thing. I borrowed a hat from.
Well, I know, but what was it?
I don't know. Something big and.
What color?
Fancy. Purple.
And lacy and
oh yeah,
was there flowers?
Flowers.
Oh Jesus!
And a hot glue gunned horse, like a toy
I think
horse,
I've seen that hat.
Like,
did you see Panera Bread's got a bread hat that they made for the Kentucky Derby?
No.
Yeah. So Panera Bread made
you can
some.
Go buy a hat.
I doubt they're available. I don't think you can just go to the store and get one. I think it's, you know, one of those online, and I'm sure they're sold out, but. Yeah, it looks like almost like a bun or something, and it's...
Oh, I get it.
Shaw coming up, some Green Day on the way. If you need something, reach out to us, rockmornings.com.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw.
It's the 150th running of the Kentucky Derby. Which horse will win? Who cares? You just want to make fun of a bunch of white people literally playing the race card. Wide-brimmed hats with fruit? Stupid. A fedora bursting in feathers? Why? A sun hat with a beaded veil that says, I'm mourning a drag queen. Tacky. Yes, the Kentucky Derby. Dumb hats. Tiny guys in neon. And horses with no clue what is going on. Is this on NBC or Essence?
Kentucky Derby tomorrow, lots of coverage, and then the fastest 2 minutes in sports.
Yep.
Not quite sure who's going to win, but I'm putting my money on both of these nuts.
Darryl, good start. Cage Fighter, both of these nuts, they come away together. Both of these nuts goes for the front. Has it by a long neck. Cage Fighter not going away easily. And DF Dynasty 3 Green right there running third. Outside, bang, bang, you're gone, making some headway. Final 100 yards for both of these nuts. Cage Fighter trying to battle back. Both of these nuts. Cage Fighter, both of these nuts rolling to victory by a head. Over Cage Fighter.
Are you putting your money on both of these nuts?
There is no both of these nuts in this year's race.
No.
All right. Well, Gene's trying to bet on the Kentucky Derby show. I don't know if you heard this.
Have you done that? It's complicated.
No, I've not done it.
Well, Gene's trying to do it online. I don't think she's ever online gambled or on an app.
I don't know what I'm doing, Sean,
at
all.
It's very funny to sit here and watch.
The only thing I've ever done is, like, pools. At, you know, put $20 on a square. Right. I've never done anything online but like this before.
Nor have I.
I'm confused and I don't
Sierra Leone is the favorite at 3-1.
3-1.
I saw that, but I don't want to do that.
She wants long odds so she can get a good payout.
Got it.
Obviously, if you take a horse that's not favored to win and they end up winning, the payout is much greater than if you were to take the favorite.
Of course.
You're
50-1, the longest odds. A couple of horses at 50-1.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to explain to her how it works, Shaw?
I get that concept.
Okay.
I understand.
All right.
That.
Sorry. Scar.
I get that.
Sorry.
I get
Sorry.
That.
Sorry.
I get
Sorry.
That.
Just, you know, trying to make sure she. What's the name of the website you're trying to gamble on?
Not the gambling
for website dummies. Or not the gambling for dummies website, but the actual, like, is it BetUS or is it DraftKings or is
none
it
none of those? I can't. I just went off
some weird Middle Eastern website.
Guido.
Yeah,
it's not some guy named Guido.
Oh, yeah. Well, it was nice knowing you.
Okay.
Gene, do you have a pair of crutches so you come to work on Monday when your knees are broken? You can make it through the door?
I think it's just going to be a small, little, tiny wager. She's maybe betting. I'll do it in person instead tomorrow at the bar where
she was complaining because she's like, you got to bet $800 to get this $200 in free bets and blah, blah, blah. I don't have $800. I got to do this surgery thing. I don't even have the $50 I'm spending.
Shaw, I don't. My dog's having surgery.
The struggle's real.
Flat tire last night with a nail in it. 120,000 mile checkup on the Rav on Monday. I don't have $800. I got $50 maybe, and that's if I don't tell my husband.
That's what credit cards are for. Well, best of luck to you.
Thanks. I'll see what I can...
Pick a winner.
She said that you can't... It's hard to discern horses from song titles.
You could play a game, Sean.
Oh, for sure.
Is a horse name in the Kentucky Derby or the name of a song? I'll figure it out.
Are you going to gamble on it, Sean, at all?
No, I never been in the Derby.
Have you ever had a mint julep, Sean?
Actually, I not. Have not had a mint
I've
julep.
Never had one either.
I had one for my first time last year when in Rome.
How do you make one? What's the sitch?
It's bourbon, right? Because that's Kentucky. So it's... Yeah. I'm glad I had one.
To say you did, yeah.
I may have one tomorrow just because I would much rather have a mojito if I'm going to have a mint drink. It was.
I think another thing at
best.
Is it the Derby where the guys run across the top of the porta potties, or is that the Preakness?
Well, I don't remember that.
Yeah, so Barstool did it for a number of years. I don't know if they still do it, but there was a horse race where a bunch of drunken frat bros would get on top of the porta potties, and you know, because there's a line of them, probably 50, 60 of them, whatever. And after you have a few tall boys, you'd get up there and you try to run the distance, almost like the grease log thing that they do, you know. Right? And while you're up there, the people are throwing beers at you the entire time, like full 16-ounce tall boys.
Oh, I see it.
Yeah.
Is the Derby.
Is it the Derby? Okay. I'm guessing.
Survivor, Kentucky Derby edition.
Right. It's sort of like, what's that golf outing? The waste management?
Waste management.
Out in
they
Arizona,
throw their beers at the guys.
Where it's crazy. So this is the post-party for the people who are not rich. The people that are cheap in the parking lot and can.
Sounds like more fun.
That I'm not running.
Up, though. They're dressed
up. Oh, yeah. Well, that's the thing, right? You got to get decked out to go to the Derby.
and then run across porta potties while beers are being thrown at your head.
What better way to celebrate a loss? Yeah.
The running of the porta potties.
Well,
oh, they also do it at Preakness too, I guess.
Spells out exactly what they're doing, Shaw. I don't need to think too hard about that.
The name is very descriptive.
Think we could do that at Oktoberfest?
I don't think they would like it if we did.
I don't think we should.
I think people like the idea of throwing beers. It was a thing for a long time.
You want to bring that back?
Of course, it was only 25 cents for a beer back then, but I ain't throwing an $8 beer. Are you kidding me? Mm-mm. Hell no.
Nope.
What else going on, Shaw?
Workers at La Crosse City Brewery are staying on the job. The brewery and Teamsters Local 695 have come to a new contract agreement, avoiding a possible strike. Union members had voted earlier in the year to authorize a strike if they couldn't reach an agreement with management by the 8th of May. City Brewery says a new contract will increase wages and benefits for the nearly 500 union employees at the La Crosse facility. An elementary school teacher in Hudson is out of the classroom and looking at criminal charges after police say she had sexual contact with a student.
This is the 11-year-old kid?
Yeah, the victim.
Dude, she's 24 and he's 11.
Yeah, the victim, an 11-year-old boy who was in 24-year-old Madison Bergman's fifth grade class at Rivercrest Elementary.
So creepy.
The boy's father went to police after finding text messages between the two. Bergman is facing possible charges of first-degree sexual assault of a child. Protests have broken out at college campuses across the U.S. as students hold rallies in support of Palestinians attacked by Israel's war in Gaza. Today, a protest takes place on the UW-La Crosse campus. The Rally for Palestine comes days after similar protests broke out on the UW-Madison campus, where 34 people were arrested. Organizers of the La Crosse event say they hope it will be peaceful. That rally takes place at 2 p.m. today at the UWL clock tower. A road up the bluff in La Crosse will be closed for much of next week for repairs.
Boy, does it need it.
Yeah, Bliss Road will be closed throughout much of the day starting Monday and lasting throughout the week. The city will be doing some stormwater infrastructure work. Bliss Road will be closed from 7 a.m. until 3 p.m. Monday through Friday. The playoff run for the Milwaukee Bucks has come to an end. The Indiana Pacers took the series title by defeating Milwaukee 120-98 yesterday, eliminating the Bucks in six games. It's the first time in 10 years that the Pacers have won a playoff series. They'll face the New York Knicks in the next round. The Bucks won just one game in the playoffs last season.
Yeah, can't win without your two top scorers.
They only had, since Doc Rivers was named the coach, I found this interesting. They only had their big three of Giannis, Dame Lillard, and Chris Middleton on the court for a total of eight games.
Wow.
No wonder, huh?
Yeah, they obviously struggled in the second half after Doc took over.
That's when the injuries mounted, though.
And then the injuries start piling up, and yeah, it just. Three-way with Shaw in the newsroom. We'll get back to him in just a bit. Got some more sports coming up in a few.
I got an insider tip here.
Okay.
Starting posts number 5 and number 10 for the horses have proved to be the luckiest. Riders assigned to those posts have won more times than any of the other starting lanes. So I got to go lane 5 or lane 10.
Got a text from Cheryl. She said, I'm with Gene. The mint julep is not very good. Had one when my son and I did a tour at the track in Kentucky the week before the Derby years ago. Not worth all the hype.
Yeah, now I understand. Some people love it, and I get that. Maybe once a year and one, but I'd rather have a mojito.
Green Day now. We'll get to some Five Finger Death Punch in a couple of minutes.
Rock Mornings on 95.7 The Rock.
Five Finger Death Punch, Never Enough, Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw. The Brew Crew off yesterday. Start a 3-game series against the Cubs in Chicago today, 1:20 first pitch. NBA tonight, Cleveland at Orlando, 6 o'clock on ESPN, game 6 of that series. Cavs are up 3-2. And the Clippers are at the Mavericks, 8:30 on ESPN, game 6 of that series. Tonight, Dallas up 3-2. Over on the ice tonight, you've got Vancouver at Nashville, 6 p.m. on TNT, Game 6. Canucks up 3-2. Dallas at Vegas at 9 p.m. on TNT for Game 6, and the Stars are up 3-2. Kentucky Derby, we've been talking about it this morning. It's tomorrow. Coverage starts at 1:30 on NBC and Peacock and runs till about 6:30. Tom Brady roast Sunday night on Netflix, 7 p.m. And Erik Jones, by the way, we'll talk racing with Doc next hour, but Erik Jones, we talked about him, broken back.
Oh, the racer? Yes, I'm sorry. Yep.
Cleared by doctors and approved to return by NASCAR earlier this week, but his Legacy Motor Club team will hold him out of this weekend's race at Kansas to allow him some more time to recover from his crash at Talladega. Corey Heim, will drive the number 43 Toyota in Sunday's race. Jones plans to be in attendance at Kansas and help crew chief Dave Ellens before returning to the driver's seat at Darlington, where he has two Cup Series wins. And remember the bee guy?
Yes, we are in a bee delay, a bee colony that has established a foothold
high
atop the backstop behind home plate, and thus we remain in a bee delay prior to game two of the series here between the Arizona Diamondbacks and the Los Angeles Dodgers. And the bees began swarming, and obviously that's an issue. Blue Sky Pest Control is on their way. The beekeeper made his way, a grand entrance onto the field here at Chase Field. He was greeted by a standing ovation by the fans here.
I thought I was here to just take care of a bee problem. And people are pretty hyped up. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, so that guy's name is Matt Hilton, and we talked about him, I think, on Wednesday. Game between the Diamondbacks and the Dodgers on Tuesday night got delayed by 2 hours because this guy was at his kid's T-ball game. Wasn't just sitting in the crowd or...
Well, like I said to you, I can't
down in the office. They don't have a bee guy.
That they have a whole... a baseball stadium has a huge crew of people that take care of maintenance and grounds.
That could be multifaceted.
And so this guy has a specific skill set that's needed.
So he shows up, full bee gear, goes out there, scissor lift, gets the bees out of there. They finally get the game started. They bring him back, and he throws out the first pitch.
And when they win, don't they?
Fans are loving it, right? While he's getting his own baseball card. I love this. Topps announced earlier this week that Matt Hilton, the beekeeper guy, signed a deal with the trading card company after safely removing the swarm of bees above home plate.
That is great.
At Chase Field before the Diamondbacks walk-off win against the Dodgers. Hilton, who drove 45 minutes from his son's T-ball game to remove the bees, has been the subject of social media adoration. The bee specialist was rewarded for his, quote, all-time great performance by throwing out the first pitch before the start of the delayed game, now also going to be immortalized with a Topps trading card.
Perfect.
One card, which can be purchased on the Topps website, will cost you about $9. And if you're lucky, you might get a card that's autographed by Hilton. Apparently they had him in, and he signed a bunch of the cards. And
of course he did. That's
$9, you can get yourself one. There you go. Matt Hilton.
Bees everywhere! God, they're huge! They're ripping my flesh off!
Son, roll around! You hear me? Roll around on the ground!
Forget that! I'm starting to swell up!
Save yourself! Don't be the hero!
Your firearms are useless against them!
More from Shaw coming up, some Blink-182 as well. Stick around.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw.
Welcome to May 3rd.
Today is National Paranormal Day.
Definitely some paranormal activity.
It's spooky.
Name one paranormal thing that happened to you.
Yeah, I've seen a ghost.
You too?
Well, I've seen a ghost.
Oh, are you paranormal investigators?
We're paranormal experts.
Are you having any paranormal issues?
Today is National Paranormal Day.
It's boo time.
National Paranormal Day, Shaw. Do you believe in the paranormal?
He does not.
I do not.
None of it.
No.
Paranormal events, phenomena described in popular culture, folk, and other non-scientific bodies of knowledge whose existence within these contexts is described as being beyond the scope of normal scientific understanding. Ghosts?
Mm-hmm.
Don't believe in them, Shaw?
No. Never seen one. It might change my mind if I did.
Bigfoot?
No.
Aliens?
No.
Clairvoyance?
Not sure on that one. Seen people do some weird stuff.
ESP?
Yeah, I think there's something to that.
Move things with your mind?
Sure, we saw Uri Geller bend a spoon.
What I think is crazy is when...
Chupacabra?
They have, missing people or situations like that for a long time, and then they bring in someone, and they've exhausted all, really have done investigative research, and then they bring in somebody in there, and they can lead them to the body.
The little lady from Poltergeist, yeah.
And that's that happens. That's crazy.
Wendigo? No?
Loch Ness?
No. Show me some proof.
I think there is stuff in the ocean that's so deep. I mean, you know, you think about
the hole that they found. The
yeah, I saw that one.
I mean, what's down there?
Well,
some stuff that's like,
I think there's stuff at the bottom of the ocean, Shaw.
That's and
the
blind real, and clear, and you
right.
can see through it.
Bioluminescence, all that kind. That would appear to be
you.
Very alien to us if we were ever to see it. Shaw doesn't believe in anything.
I'm a nihilist.
I'll stand firmly on this. I think the universe is too big for there not to be aliens. And we're seeing more and more of it with the government releasing documents and all that stuff, that there's stuff flying around out there, Shaw, that we don't even know what the hell it is.
Yeah, people claim they've seen things, for sure.
I don't know if it's little green men, but there's something.
The supernatural?
I think not necessarily ghosts, like a floating apparition type thing, but an energy.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Kind of thing. I mean, have you know, and maybe it's the placebo effect. You know, you walk into a creepy old
there's the chill
house,
or the
if
door
you're willing
shut,
to believe,
the
yes.
thing.
Right, if your brain's tricking you into releasing those chemicals, you know what I mean, and saying, we got to get out of here, it's haunted as F, you know, then you're probably thinking a place is haunted.
Get out.
Right, you hear the get out. I don't know so much about, you know, the whole we only use 10% of our minds, and if we could open up and use all 100%, we could move things and we could fly and float and all this crap and bending spoons. That stuff I find to be chicanery.
Mm-hmm. Jedi stuff, you mean?
Yeah. Well, like Shaw mentioned, Uri Geller bending a spoon.
Right.
It's a parlor trick, right? There's got to be some sort of heating up of the metal or something, or it's very thin metal and you're able to, you know, rub it and press it so that it bends in some way, shape, or form, right, Shaw? Something along
sure.
those lines?
It's got to be a reason, you know, an explanation.
I mean, even magic. You know, you watch magicians, guys who do card tricks and stuff like that, and it's phenomenal stuff.
It's sleight of hand, though.
Right, but you could watch that and you could say,
oh, yeah, you have no idea how they did it.
How did you get the cigarette through the quarter? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? How did the card end up in my wallet?
I saw one the other day where he transferred a Sharpie X on the palm to the palm of another person.
Yeah.
How the hell do you do that, Shaw?
Good
the
question.
The ones that get me are when the cards appear in other people's pockets and stuff like that with marker on them.
Like I said, the Sharpie was on his hand, and then it was on her hand, and there was no, like, hand touching.
One of our coworkers was recently in Vegas and went to see David Copperfield and actually got up on stage during the show and was standing next to someone who David Copperfield made disappear. And she has no idea how any of that happened. She was right there.
Yeah. Paranormal day, Shaw. Get out and investigate.
Do something freaky.
Go out in the woods and make Bigfoot mating calls.
Is that how it sounds?
I don't know. It sounded like Harry and the Hendersons.
Don't do that, maybe.
What else is happening?
City Brewery in La Crosse has reached a new contract agreement with their local union employees. A new 5-year contract between the company and Teamsters Local 695 reportedly will provide wage and benefit hikes affecting almost 500 brewery workers. A statement released by City Brewery thanks the company's bargaining team and union leaders for working out the agreement. Union members had voted this spring to authorize a strike if a new contract could not be worked out before the existing contract ends on Wednesday. The city of La Crosse is no longer renting out hotels to house the homeless. In fact, the city is not providing any housing for the homeless currently and have cleared out local encampments. But La Crosse County is spending some big bucks to house the unsheltered. A program called Thriving Families is a collaboration between Cooley Cab, Catholic Charities, and La Crosse County. The program got a boost when the county funneled $3 million in federal ARPA money to help buy 13 local houses to be used to house the homeless. 4 families have already been housed through that program. The goal is to buy up about 20 more properties by the end of 2025. The message of Save Social Security is being spread throughout Wisconsin. An informational picket happened yesterday outside the Social Security office in downtown La Crosse. Demonstrators are calling on Washington to fully fund the agency's budget and to protect entitlements. Similar picketing has been done in other cities around the state since late March. A plan to legalize sports betting in Minnesota apparently has stalled in the wake of an arrest of a state senator. Lawmakers from both parties are angry over the charges that have been filed against Senator Nicole Mitchell, who's accused accused of breaking into her estranged stepmother's home to steal her father's ashes.
Yeah.
Backers of the betting bill have doubts that the plan can move forward now following the controversy over Mitchell.
We talked about this while you were gone on vacation, and it sounds like they live next door to each other.
Oh, okay.
And have for a while, and there's apparently been a rift.
Some bad blood, I would imagine.
With the stepmother, who still lives there, I guess, and she was trying to go over there and take her dead father's ashes, mm-hmm. and the stepmother calls the cops, and yeesh.
Yeah, and she's a politician.
What a mess.
And the playoff run for the Milwaukee Bucks now over after the Indiana Pacers defeated Milwaukee 120-98 to take that series 4-1.
What do we know about the Pat Beverly thing? What the hell happened there?
I don't know. Tell me.
You didn't see it?
No, I didn't.
Oh, okay. So he came out of the game in the fourth with about 2.5 to go.
Yeah.
Heads to the bench. They're down by a ton, so yeah, they're obviously out. Back. And, you know, probably upset, frustrated, the whole nine yards. And, this fan is, like, right behind the bench. So maybe they were chirping him the whole entire game. I don't know.
Okay.
But the guy that was sitting behind him had a basketball. And at one point, Pat Beverly calls for the ball. It looks like he calls for it. The guy tosses it to him lightly, and Pat immediately grabs it and then two-hands it right back at him about a million miles an hour. Almost like a dodgeball, two-handed dodgeball shot. And I don't know if he was just pissed and, you know, wanted to bean the guy or what the sitch was, or if the guy was chirping him the whole game. I didn't know if you had had any update on
that. No, I'm just looking at a video of it right now on ESPN's website.
He chucked it at a female and hit her in the head.
But the female wasn't who threw him the ball.
And then he requested a ball from a different fan and threw it back at him.
Why do fans have balls in the stands? I'm lost at that part.
So I'm assuming you can buy them at the pro shop, right?
Maybe, I guess.
So these fans were looking for him to autograph the ball or something like that?
It doesn't really say. It just says, right. And this is what that
just a weird interaction, you know? I mean, like,
you
know.
He will most certainly be disciplined, not ejected, but did not appear again. And it was unclear if either the man or the woman were fans and
they were Pacer fans.
Well, they were Pacer fans based on what they were wearing.
They're wearing Pacer jerseys.
Yeah. I tell you what, man, those NBA situations, it's amazing that more bad stuff doesn't happen with how close some of those fans are. Mm-hmm. I mean, some of the fans are right there next to the bench. You look at, like, you know, at the Celtics game, Donnie Wahlberg and his wife, Robert Kraft.
They're right there.
I mean, granted, you're probably not going to mess around when you're spending millions and millions of dollars to sit next to the bench, but they're right next to the coach and the players. Mm-hmm. I mean, like, literally on the same row. Then you get the people behind them and you get some opposing fans. I mean, think about the Joel Embiid thing that was going on where they're chanting F Joel, all this stuff, like. Bucks done, though.
Yeah, Timberwolves will play in the second round starting tomorrow. They face off against the Denver Nuggets, tip-off at 6 tomorrow night.
Yeah, they're working on some kind of special chair for their coach.
Yeah, after he blew out his knee.
Yeah, a little collision there. Ruptured his patellar tendon.
Patrick put on Twitter last night, apparently, not fair at all, exchanged between a fan and our ball club last night. We warned and asked for help all night long and got nothing.
I'm sure there's more to the story. And obviously, he let his emotions get the best of him there at the end. But
so maybe that was a problem, and they kept saying some.
That's kind of what I assumed, was that there was some back and forth, and the guy was probably chirping him the whole game and saying some stuff, and maybe said something that crossed the line. And yeah, three-way with Shaw. We'll get back to him in just a bit, and also talk racing with Doc. We'll get to bad news, happy music. The dense fog advisory continues. Please remember to keep your lights on this morning. It's still pretty foggy out there. Pantera.
Rock Mornings on your rock station.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. That, of course, Pantera with Walk. Got some AC/DC coming up in a few minutes. Doc will join us to talk racing at about 8:25. One more three-way with Shaw, plus bad news, happy music. Travis going out on a complete limb here. National Paranormal Day. You were talking about walking into a room where someone's been killed and they bring in a clairvoyant, the police, they ask some.
No, I mean, there have been stories that have happened over time where investigators have been looking for someone who has.
Right, like a cold case.
A cold case. And then they bring in a
clairvoyant.
Clairvoyant, and they can eventually
help them solve the case.
Yes.
I've watched
or
a lot
find
of,
the body or whatever.
I've watched a lot of those Netflix series.
Mm-hmm.
Travis, with a bit of a stretch here, says, what if they lead you to the body because they put the body there?
The clairvoyant killed the person and then turned into a clairvoyant. So
well, yeah.
Years later, the cops could call them.
If you're Ed Gein and they just arrested you and you know where the bodies are, yeah, I don't know about this clairvoyant. Like, I know what I'll do. I'll kill somebody, stash the body, become a clairvoyant, and in 30 years, when they come looking for help, I'll be the one to help him solve the murder.
Because I know where I put it.
Travis, take the tinfoil hat off, okay, bud? It's Friday.
TGIF. Come on.
Okay. Yeah, man. Like, you see what happened was that, like, Claire wanted to kill the body.
That's
and put
a life
it in that
plan, though. I mean, you got to.
That is long game. That is long game right there. That is very long game.
Definition of it.
Yeah. We'll get to that AC/DC in a few.
More of your Rock Mornings coming up in just a bit.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. AC/DC back in black. Josie Scott, lead singer of Saliva, at least former lead singer of Saliva, 52 years old today. Looking good.
Mm-hmm.
Got his life back on track. Josie Scott, 52. This guy is 73.
Sailing, takes me away.
Christopher Cross, Sailing, Ride Like the Wind, Arthur's Theme, Best That You Can Do. Widely responsible for Yacht Rock, I guess.
Yes.
Most people would associate him as the man in charge of Yacht Rock, Christopher Cross. Frankie Valli. How old do you think Frankie Valli is? Four Seasons.
101.
90. Leader of the Four Seasons, Jersey Boys, about them, obviously. Did the theme to Grease. Big Girls Don't Cry, Walk Like a Man. Oh, What a Night, December 1963.
We have a coworker who's taking her mother to see him.
Gee, I wonder who that is.
See him?
Yeah, 90.
And he's still
performing at the age of 90?
Apparently.
Is it in Vegas?
I think Texas, I think.
Okay. I'm sure Brittany and Lorna will have a good time. Frankie Valli, 90. The godfather of soul, the hardest working man in show business, the king of funk, Mr. Please, 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 Please Her, soul brother number one, the sex machine, James Brown, born on this day in 1933.
Fellas, I'm ready to get up and do my thing.
Go ahead.
I want to get into it, man, you know. Like a sex machine, man. Moving, doing it, you know. Can I count it off? One, two, three, four. Get up. Get on up.
James Brown. Born on this day in 1933, died in 2006.
Rosemont Horizon, I was wrong.
Okay.
Chicago.
Ann B. Davis, born on this day in 1926. You know her better as Alice from the Brady Bunch. Died on in 2014. Sam the Butcher delivered too much meat, killed her. No?
That's not what happened.
Is that not what happened?
It was a ring bologna accident, is that what you're saying?
She got some tainted meat from Sam the Butcher.
No, I don't think so.
Meat on the taint. Bing Crosby, born on this day in 1903, died in 1977.
Live, folks, it's your old pal Bing Crosby. You know, I reckon Christmas about my favorite time of year. Get to listen to great Christmas music. It seems the kids these days don't want to hear the old standards. Got to change with the times. That's why I'm announcing my new Bing Crosby rap CD.
Yes, it's Bing Crosby's Rappin' Christmas. 15 holiday classics mixed by legendary rappers like LL Cool J, P. Diddy, and more. You'll get Christmas gems like Frosty the Snowman.
Frosty the Snowman, a jolly happy soul, had a corn cob crack pot. That's how he rolled.
That is not a real album, and I may have to edit it to take out the P. Diddy at this point. That is from a long time ago.
Uh-huh.
Ron Popeil, born on this day in 1935, died in 2021.
And set it and forget it.
Pocket Fisherman, Hair in a Can, Smokeless Ashtray, Chop-O-Matic, Veg-O-Matic, Inside the Shell, Egg Scrambler, and many others. The king of You've Seen It on TV. Ron Popeil. Set it and forget it. May 3rd, 1976, Aerosmith released their fourth album, Rocks, featuring Back in the Saddle, Last Child, and many others. On this day, May 3rd, in 1988, Living Color released their debut album, Vivid, featuring their smash hit, The Cult of Personality, also Glamour Boys, and Open Letter to a Landlord.
You can tear a building down, erase a memory.
Love that song. By far my favorite Living Color tune.
Yeah.
Just incredible. 1988, same day, Queenstrike released their concept album, Operation Mindcrime, featuring Eyes of a Stranger, I Don't Believe in Love, Operation Mindcrime, from Queenstrike. in stores on this day in 1988. 1991, 33 years ago, Dallas, the original, aired its series finale on CBS. Over 33 million people tuned in, making it the 12th highest rated series finale ever, just behind Frasier. Crazy. Never got into it. Never got into it. Not my jam. On this day in 1996, Witches in theaters, The Craft.
Light as a feather, stiff as a board.
Feruza Balk, and you got Robin Tunney in that one as well. And yeah, The Craft. Witches. They remade it. It's really bad.
It's
just like every other reboot. It's awful. It's trash. 2002. 22 years ago today, the original, I guess, Spider-Man was in theaters starring Tobey Maguire. Before the Andrew Garfield and Tom Holland versions. Here comes the Spider-Man. He's got radioactive blood. Also on this day in 2005, Nine Inch Nails released their fourth album, With Teeth, featuring... That Feeds, Only, Every Day is Exactly the Same, and many others. And I have to play this because of my wife. I'm required by law. It's in our marital contract.
What is it?
19 years ago today, 2005, Fall Out Boy released From Under the Cork Tree, featuring...
This was in the paperwork you guys signed, is that you have to recognize the release of Fall Out Boy.
I think it was part of the marriage vows, too. Like, do you promise to play Fall Out Boy on the anniversary of their release date? Yes, I do, Your Honor.
Ever and ever and always.
It's her favorite band. I've had to go see them multiple times. Thankfully, that, I think, has come to an end. We'll see. But there you go. Some birthdays and pop culture dates. We got some Offspring in a few, and we'll talk racing with Doc. Stick around.
Rock Mornings. On air. Online. On the app.
Three-way with Shaw in the newsroom. What's happening, dude?
Well, there is no school again today in the Mount Horeb School District following Wednesday's fatal shooting at the school. Students have not been in class there since Wednesday morning when a 14-year-old student armed with a rifle was shot dead by police outside the middle school. Protests have broken out at college campuses across the country as students hold rallies in support of Palestinians attacked by Israel's war in Gaza. Today, a protest will take place on the UW La Crosse campus. This rally for Palestine comes days after similar protests broke out on the UW Madison campus, where 34 people were arrested. There have been protests at many college campuses nationwide. Organizers of the La Crosse event say they hope it will be peaceful. That rally takes place starting at 2 p.m. today at the UWL clock tower. The message of Save Social Security is being spread throughout Wisconsin. An informational picket happened yesterday outside the Social Security office in downtown La Crosse. Demonstrators are calling on Washington to fully fund the agency's budget and to protect entitlements. The group included Jessica LaPointe, president of a union council for Social Security workers in Wisconsin. She says cuts in funding for the Bureau can lead to delays in citizens getting their government benefits.
Baby boomers are retiring at a rate of 12,000 a week. And Congress has not met that demand. In fact, they have slashed Social Security's operating budget by more than 20% over the last decade.
Similar picketing has been done in other cities around the state since late March. The water park capital of the world will have a new record-breaking attraction in time for Memorial Day. The Mount Olympus Resort at the Wisconsin Dells is finishing construction of the Rise of Icarus, which reportedly will be the tallest water slide in the U.S. at 145 feet in height. It will still be 19 feet shorter than the world's tallest slide, which is located at a park in Brazil. This new slide is named after the character Icarus from Greek mythology, who tried flying with giant wings. He fell into the sea when the wax that was holding the wings together melted after Icarus got too close to the sun.
And you said you don't believe in the paranormal.
That's right. And the farmer's market season is getting underway. Vendors in La Crosse traditionally sell their items at Cameron Park downtown on Friday nights from May through October, starting around 4 p.m. That will begin for the season tonight. Also this weekend, the farmer's market will be held in Eau Claire. In La Crosse, for the second straight season, there will not be a market in the park on Saturday mornings, as there used to be, because of the reduced turnout for Saturdays in recent years.
Bad news, happy music coming up in a bit. What do we got to look forward to?
Let's see. An Iowa man should have cleared the drugs out of his car before he turned himself into police.
Oh, man. All right. More on that during Bad News with Happy Music. Got Doc joining us to talk racing. We'll get to him right after the Offspring.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. The Offspring got to get away. Friday mornings during race season, right about 8:25, we talk racing with Doc. The mid-pack legend, Mr. Technicality, car 54, Billy Doc Niles, a.k.a. Captain Retirement, a.k.a. hashtag Mr. Fister, a.k.a. hashtag this guy.
Happy July.
In a voicemail, no less. Messed it up in a voicemail. Happy 4th of July. Hashtag this guy.
I'm kind of anal.
Ooh, he's kind of anal. Hashtag this guy.
He's got it locked on the rock. He's listening to the doc.
That was Shorty in Florida, right? Hashtag this guy.
You're getting a thrill by listening to Bill.
Hashtag this guy.
Gonna have to come from the back.
That one kills me. Hashtag this guy.
He gets to stay on the box.
That one too. Hashtag this guy.
Whoa, what am I touching here?
Whoa, what are you touching here, Doc?
Well, I am touching my concert tickets. I cannot wait to go tomorrow night because everybody knows you can't rock without Doc.
Oh, geez.
Oh, man. Yeah, that's okay. All right. Racing, Doc. What's going on this weekend?
Well, like Brian mentioned about an hour ago, Eric Jones was cleared to race, which was kind of a shock to a lot of people. So that means his back couldn't have been as bad as they first explained to us, but as to show an overabundance of caution, the Legacy Motor Club is going to hold him out again this week and put Corey Heim back in the car. He did a pretty decent job. He got 25th last week, so the kid did a pretty good job. He's got a bright future in front of him. Also, coming up in a couple of weeks, you know, we got the All-Star Race going on at North Wilkesboro Speedway, but the same weekend, we're also going to be practicing and qualifying for the Indianapolis 500. Kyle Larson is going to have a car in that trying to qualify for that Indy 500. So he's not going to be there for practicing qualifying for the All-Star Race. So Kevin Harvick's going to come out of the booth, practice and qualify the car for Larson. So Larson has a starting spot, and Larson will show up and run in the All-Star Race. So it's pretty cool. Harvick gets back behind the wheel one more time. They are at Kansas Speedway this week. It's a mile-and-a-half D-shaped oval, one of the cookie cutters like we talk about to try to look like Charlotte or Atlanta. Variable-degree banking, 17 to 20-degree banking. Pretty decent qualifying record set by Harvick back in 2014 at 197.6 miles an hour. Winner of this race last year was Denny Hamlin. If you remember, he knocked Kyle Larson out of the way to win it. And then the winner during the chase was Tyler Reddick. That 45 car has won that fall race 3 years in a row with three different drivers. So there's something to look out for come October when they go back to that race. Fantasy experts, they like Larson, Reddick, and Hamlin. When I filled mine out last night, you look at guys who are either good at this track or good at mile and a halfs. Truex, Byron, Larson, Logano, just to name a few. VegasInsider.com via the BetMGM app brings us our odds this week. Larson at plus 350, Hamlin at plus 450, Reddick at plus 600, Byron and Truex at 800, Bell at 1,000. Now, before we go any further, I want to wish a happy birthday to a member of the vaunted Fest Tower gang. Happy 53rd birthday to Kevin Ramsell. Listening on the app down in Stoughton right there. Probably the most genius move he's ever made in his life. You know, he's also the PR director of the Midwest Tour, so happy birthday to you, Kevin. Red Cedar Speedway tonight. Now, we've had a lot of rain in the area, so they're trying desperately to prep the track. They're going to do their best to get it, so pay attention to their social media, especially Facebook. They're going to give you all the updates. But if we do get racing in tonight, it's Support Local Racing and College Student Night. All college student with valid student ID are admitted for just $5 to tonight's show. Midwest Mods, Modified, Street Stocks, Super Stocks, Red Cedar Hornets, all in action. Gates open at 5 o'clock. Practice at 6:30. First green flag drops at 7 o'clock. Like I mentioned, pay attention to Facebook especially. They're going to do their best to prep that track and get it ready for tonight's show. And like you mentioned in a text earlier today, big World of Outlaws late model show going on at Mississippi Thunder Speedway. It's a two-day event tonight and tomorrow. Again, with that one, pay attention to your socials. They'll let you know what the schedule changes are made so they can get that show in. with Full Racing TV cutting back on weekly racing, the La Crosse Fairground Speedway is going to go in a different direction. They are currently finalizing plans to provide their own live stream. Stay tuned to their website and Facebook and, of course, to this race report, and we'll give you all the details on that. And remember, folks, wherever you're at in the country, get out and support a local short track. Doc, Smoker calendar is empty this weekend, and there's nothing on it for next weekend so far. So I think we'll put Doc Smoker calendar to bed for the 2024 season. Thank you to everybody who put their parties on the Midwest Racing Smokers page so we can get that information out. We'll do it again next year. This race report has been brought to you by our friends at County Materials on Empire Street in Holman. That is this week's race report.
DOC joining us on the phone each and every Friday during NASCAR race season to talk racing. And big thanks to him, and look forward to hanging out with him and his lovely wife tomorrow night. I'm going to kiss her right on the lips, right in front of him, too, as I always do. Beartooth in a few minutes, and Bad News Happy Music coming up next.
Rock Mornings, only on 95.7 The Rock.
You're about to enter a beautiful, exciting, wonderful new world.
A cockroach living in your nostril.
Now that's just nasty.
Add in some haven't pooped for 30 days.
Poop is raining from the ceilings. Poop.
And sprinkle in some hashtag Florida Man for flavor.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man quits his Burger King job, steals all of their chicken nuggets.
It's Bad News.
Bad News.
With Happy Music.
Let's rock.
A Friday edition, usually jam-packed with goodness. What do we got today, Shaw?
Well, is a surge in unemployment just around the corner? Automation and continuing economic uncertainty have a quarter of American workers feeling the pressure at their place of work, worrying that their jobs may disappear this year. A new survey of 2,000 employed adults looked at how workers see themselves in their current roles, finding that many believe they will receive a pink slip sooner rather than later. Their concerns stem from distress about the job market and knowing that they work in an unstable business or industry. People also face challenges keeping up with their professions. 32% are worried that they're falling behind or lack the skills they need to be successful. That may be because 55% feel like they've been doing the same job for years.
And a
similar percentage admitted that their skill sets feel outdated. The survey also finds many workers think it's time for a refresh, perhaps a time to look for a new career. The IRS says it's about to ramp up audits as it cracks down on tax cheats and seeks to deliver more revenue into the U.S. Treasury. But not every group of taxpayers will face more scrutiny, according to IRS Commissioner Danny Werfel. The IRS has been boosted by $80 billion in new funding directed by the Inflation Reduction Act, signed into law in 2022 by President Biden. The idea behind the new funding was to help revive an agency whose ranks have been depleted over the years, leading to customer service snarls, processing delays, and a fall-off in audit rates. Yesterday, the IRS outlined its plans for the funding. They say the money has helped the IRS answer more taxpayer calls during the tax season that just ended, as well as beef up its enforcement, which led to the collection of $520 million from wealthy taxpayers who hadn't filed their taxes or still owed money. The IRS's strategic plan over the next 3 years includes a sharp increase in audits, although the agency says it will not be boosting enforcement for those who earn less than $400,000 a year, which covers the bulk of U.S. taxpayers.
Am I the only person who feels like, similar to Stop, Drop, and Roll, and how important that was when we were a kid, I thought I'd be on fire a lot more often. With the IRS, I felt like we were going to get audited all the time. Right. Like, it felt like growing up, that was like a real serious,
a real scary. You might go to prison.
Scary thing. Yeah. Like, and when, yeah, I mean, like, when
keep
you
all
enter,
your documents.
Well, when you enter the job, you know, the workplace or whatever, when you're 15, 16, and you get this 10, and you're like, oh my God, they're going to audit me. They're coming to my house. Right. They're going to put me in. Like, and then you grow up and you're like, eh.
So they are going to do more audits, but the audits are going to be focused almost exclusively on wealthy individuals and large corporations.
Good. Fine. Right. Have at it.
Yeah, well, then you hear these.
You explain your loopholes and your things and your stuff.
You hear these ads and, like, hasn't paid taxes in 10 years. What? What?
Right.
You can get away with it for 10 years. What?
And it's perfectly legal because of the way the tax code is written.
Yeah. I mean, I just, again, similar to the Stop, Drop, and Roll thing, it felt like the IRS was living next door to me and just waiting for me to slip up at the age of 16 so they could come and kill me and put me in jail forever. It's very scary.
I understand, but you can rest easy now.
All right.
This sounds like a scene from Raising Arizona. In South Carolina, a sheriff's office says a 25-year-old man was arrested after an armed robbery at a Dollar General store. Corey Felder Jr. is charged with armed robbery and unlawful carrying of a pistol. He's accused of stealing two boxes of diapers from a Dollar General while armed with a pistol. He was previously convicted of domestic violence in 2023, which prohibits him from carrying a firearm.
Just some diapers, that's it?
Right, diapers. I assumed that there was a need for the diapers.
Yeah.
They arrested the guy about a mile away from the store. He was wearing the same clothes that he was seen wearing in the surveillance video.
Now, listen, you folks can't stay here.
Ma'am?
Ma'am?
You just can't stay. Now, I appreciate you being friends of high and all, but this is a decent family now.
I think he stole diapers, too, yeah. Commissioners in one Tennessee county are butting heads over how to improve their county's EMS response time. These response time problems have been well documented in Meigs County, Tennessee. One woman who was waiting for an ambulance, it never showed up as her husband was dying. It's not an isolated case. Now, the current EMS director for the county, a man named Tony Fennell, was confronted about the response time during a recent public safety meeting, and many were left stunned at his response. When asked about the long response times for the ambulances to get to the patients, he said, "We're all going to die. My suggestion to you is to get your heart right with God."
Whoa, that dude is going to be taking a little vacation, it sounds like.
Yeah, bro, some critics say a lot of us were left stunned. That was the level or lack thereof of empathy from the EMS director.
Don't get me wrong. I appreciate the guy's honesty, but...
Well, right, but that doesn't...
You can't say that.
Just because we're all
going to
die
dying.
Doesn't mean you can't send an ambulance when somebody needs one.
So was there a reason why the ambulance never showed up for this lady when her husband...
Apparently, it's not an isolated case. For whatever reason, in this county, they have a real problem with their response times, and people are literally dying waiting for an ambulance.
Oh, my gosh.
Cedar Rapids, Iowa man was arrested after police said he flashed a handgun at a driver in a road rage incident. 36-year-old Sean Pettit is charged with assault while displaying a dangerous weapon. Police were called by a driver who was heading south on the interstate. They say a heavyset bald man driving a Chevy Silverado...
Costanza?
Had flashed a handgun at them after brake checking in front of them. The caller told police the driver was driving extremely fast, well over the speed limit, and weaving in and out of traffic. Police found the truck, and the man admitted to having a handgun in his vehicle and admitted to having a confrontation with the victim while driving fast and weaving in and out of traffic. Police say they found the handgun in the center console of the truck this guy was driving.
Good. Bad. I'm the guy with the gun.
He was a short, stocky, bald man.
He was. Lived with his mother.
Lived with his mother. Summer of George.
Right.
He was out there on the Summer of George. Mm-hmm. Is that his deal? Serenity now!
We've heard a lot about Ozempic, the weight loss.
Oh, my gosh.
It's already been linked to a host of bizarre bodily changes, including sagging skin and sunken-in cheeks.
Well, if you're really big and you lose a lot of weight, that skin's not changing.
That's
it's staying
exactly
there.
Right. Now, women are reporting a side effect they call Ozempic breasts, which is when their boobs either shrink or balloon in size. Doctors say the former is to be expected because as someone loses weight, fat tissue in the breasts also
diminishes.
Making them smaller.
Gene.
But the latter is more surprising. One line of thinking is that hormonal fluctuations in the body may be causing temporary breast swelling or tenderness.
Swelling.
Another theory is that as people become skinnier, their breasts simply appear to be bigger.
It's a mind trick.
Still, dozens of women have been left feeling disappointed or, in some cases, pleasantly surprised due to the phenomenon. Those breasts can be quite large. Mm-hmm.
They can be quite large, Shaw.
Or well,
I do have big breasts.
Yeah, they get bigger and bigger and bigger.
Isn't Oprah on the Ozempic?
I think she is.
Yeah.
There's a lot of people on it all of a sudden.
It's you can just get it? Well, how do you get it? You just go and get it?
I was Googling some of that.
I saw people
week.
Are getting tainted Ozempic on TikTok. First of all, you're a moron if you're getting drugs off of somebody on TikTok. Some sort of...
Ozempic is a diabetes drug. That
it's
was
not
its
even
design,
right. The side effect,
but
is
it's
that,
often prescribed by doctors for weight loss.
So if I go in and I'm like, "Look, man, I'm lazy and I don't feel like working out. Mm-hmm. Can you give me the Ozempic and we'll be good?" And he's like, "Yeah, sure, whatever." And they write you a script.
Yeah, I think so.
America, healthcare, America.
I don't.
I mean, hey, dude, if it's great for diabetes, good for them. You know all that stuff, but like, so can you just go in and get it?
Well, I don't know. I don't know.
It needs to be prescribed by a doctor. You can't just go to a drugstore and get it. But.
Well, as we've seen before, you can just go into the back alleyway and get a butt injection. Maybe there's some doctor in an alleyway.
Maybe. I think you... They might be a little bit more concerned than that, unless you're rich or a celebrity or whatever.
They can get drugs anywhere. Mm-hmm. They don't, whatever.
You like to travel light? One cruise ship, soon to set sail from Florida, is making sure that all you need is the bare necessities. No shoes, no clothes, but plenty of service.
Ooh.
The Big Nude Boat will take travelers from Miami to the Caribbean on an 11-day adventure back to Paradise, according to their website.
Seen a grown man naked?
Yeah, he was on the Paradise trip.
Setting sail from February 3rd through Valentine's Day of next year, the trip offers what they call a stress-free, clothes-free experience, during which up to 2,300 passengers can roam the ship in the nude while out at sea.
You know what's probably really gross, Shaw? Is getting one of those noroviruses when you have no clothes to cover up all your nastiness. You know, imagine all the people pooping and puking and their naked bodies everywhere and no thanks.
Passengers will not be allowed to be naked when the ship is docked, but they can ditch their usual attire once they're anchored or out in the water. And when clothing is optional, the standard nudist etiquette still applies, so that when sitting, nude passengers must either wear a thong or sit on a towel or some kind of fabric.
So your exposed private parts aren't touching everything?
And passengers must be dressed for all dining room meals.
Oh, yeah, sure. They say it's a nude cruise, and then you got to put clothes on to eat food.
Right.
Get out of here. You know when I do my best work on a hamburger? When I'm topless on the floor, half drunk like Hasselhoff. This is a mess.
It's how can the best time to have no shirt on. I don't have any clothes on.
It turns out you don't have to hurt someone to be charged with a crime. Police in Florida responded to a trespassing at a convenience store the other day, and one of the cops was assaulted. The officer was hit by a cheeseburger that had been forcibly thrown at his thigh.
Forcibly?
By a 73-year-old man who was handcuffed.
Come on.
What?
If you're thinking this probably didn't leave a mark, you'd be wrong. According to the police report, the cop observed residue from the burger on his thigh, six inches beneath his belt line.
Was he wearing shorts?
No, I don't think so.
Come on, man. You can't go back to the police station and get in front of your...
I got some ketchup on my leg. Hurt.
You can't get in front of your coworkers and claim foul with this cheeseburger thing. Come on, man. It's like that hot dog lady. Remember her? She got beamed by the hot dog. Mm-hmm. They were firing him out of a cannon. This guy just got hit by some 73-year-old dude throwing out a double cheeseburger at him.
That was
handcuffs? I think
he'll
be okay, yeah.
Oh, my. That was hand... How much spin can you put on a cheeseburger when you're handcuffed?
Yeah, the man was ultimately charged with trespassing and battery on a law enforcement officer, which is a felony. This guy has a long rap sheet that includes being arrested 2 years ago for trying to hit a cop with a metal pole.
All right, now that one I'll give you.
I get.
Metal pole, fine. Yeah. Cheeseburger, come on, bro.
73-year-old.
Maybe police work is not for you. If you're getting assaulted by a 73-year-old guy handcuffed with a cheeseburger and you're claiming some kind of insurance scam, come on, bro. Maybe police work is not what you're fit out, you know, you're fit for.
I'm not sure what was going on here, but in Houston, Texas, deputies opened fire and killed a man who they say failed to obey commands to drop a knife while standing in the middle of the street. The sheriff's office said they got a call about a man cutting or stabbing himself while standing in the road. Deputies found the man who was impeding traffic and stabbing himself with a knife.
Nope.
They used verbal commands to try to disarm the man before successfully using less than lethal force, which the sheriff's office did not immediately specify, so rubber bullets or beanbags, perhaps. Then the man began advancing toward deputies, leading them to discharge their service weapons, hitting the man who died at the scene. The sheriff's office said the man, who was covered in blood, was also holding a 3-by-2-foot wooden cross over his head, smearing the blood from his injuries. An investigation is now underway to figure out just what unfolded.
I wonder if the cops have, like, a bigger beanbag deployment system.
Like, how so?
Like, the beanbag, based on my limited knowledge of what they've got over there, Shaw, the beanbag comes from, like, a shotgun, right?
Mm-hmm.
And it's, you know, a little bit smaller than a cornhole bag, right? It's maybe about yay big, like kind of a ravioli size. Mm-hmm. What if they get like a cannon size beanbag, like for like a pillow,
like this,
like you just, you know, I'm sure those beanbags hurt. They're probably not very fun to deal with.
They leave a mark.
But man, if you hit, if you, you know, non-lethal beanbag pillow,
just like, take them right down,
just pa-poom
down to the ground.
Yeah, so like maybe back them up about 20 feet.
That would have been helpful in this case.
You hit the guy, pow! Right? Just like in a movie, like, woo! Mm-hmm.
And if you get pulled over and police find something illegal in your car, there isn't really much you can do. But if you were turning yourself into police, you would probably have plenty of time to get rid of any incriminating evidence.
You'd think.
Still, an Iowa City man who voluntarily turned himself in on an arrest warrant is now facing other charges after allegedly bringing drugs with him in his car. 20-year-old Prashu Nzoni reportedly turned himself into police on a second-degree robbery charge. He pulled up in his 2009 Audi and parked his car, and it was then searched. A warrant was secured and executed. Officers located over 20 blue pills, $440 in cash commonly associated with drug transactions, nearly 3 grams of suspected marijuana, 3 pieces of aluminum foil with burnt residue, 2 rolled dollar bills with burnt residue. And the pills were sent for testing. They were determined to be fentanyl. The marijuana was also positively identified. This guy additionally charged with a controlled substance violation, marijuana possession, and possession of drug paraphernalia. So in addition to the robbery charges, if convicted on these additional charges, he would face another 6 to 10 years in prison. Maybe you should have cleaned your car first, sir.
I just got a message from my guy, Adam. Said, here you go. It's not a beanbag, but it'll drop you.
Oh, yeah.
Stanislaus State Police incorporate 40-millimeter launchers, sponge-tipped projectiles. There's a video.
Yeah?
I'm going to watch this video.
Okay.
I just thought that maybe a big pillow-sized beanbag might do the trick as well, Shaw. Because
this guy was shot with non-lethal, you know, weapons, and he continued to advance. It didn't have any effect on him.
I'll watch the hell out of that Code Blue Cam video on YouTube. See some
somebody
cops.
Take him down.
Like a cannon. They bring the cannon out of the back of the truck and boom! Sir, drop the knife in the cross or we're going to cannon you with this beanbag that looks like a pillow. I'd pay money to see that. Oh, yeah. All right, I'm watching this thing. The guy opens the door. There's the gun. It's in the vehicle. Oh, it's like one of those, it's like in the movies Arnold when he launches the grenades, the grenade launcher thing. Oh, snap. Look at that thing. That looks like fun.
Did he take him down yet?
Chief Clint Strode from Stanislaus, the state police department. Look at him. He's just, yeah, this guy. He's only got a little holster there for like 3 of them. It's got one of those handles at the right by the barrel, Shaw. Just hold. All right, enough with, just show me the thing shooting. They don't shoot it. It's just this lady holding it up like
it's a bad video. Who sent this to you? Your Adam. Buddy Adam? Adam.
I want the video where they shoot it.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to have to find that myself, apparently. Thank you, Shaw. Have a good weekend. We'll talk to you on Monday. Sponge-tipped projectiles.
Yeah, but nothing's happening.
Yeah, it's just... That was...
That was anticlimactic.
Very.
Adam.
Adam, watch the video first, then make sure it's got the shooting part. I want to see the shooting.
Rock Mornings. Monday to Friday, 6 to 9. Call.
Hello.
Email.
I tried emailing you.
Text. So many ways to check in with us.
Check, check.
We rely on you guys for traffic updates, requests, and all sorts of other stuff.
Check this out.
Find us on rockmornings.com. All the contact info there. If you want to email or text us or give us a call, find our Facebook feed there. All that stuff. Jamie texted in and said, how about a hot dog gun for less lethal? If anything, it can distract with hunger. So rather than a beanbag gun, you got a hot dog cannon, like a potato, like a boiled potato cannon or something like that. I could, yeah. You're running away from the cops. You think you're getting away. And then all of a sudden,
bam,
hot dog right in the back of the head. You're like, oh, snap. I was kind of hungry. Thank you. Shorty. Listening down in Florida, Doc's Racing Report. Said, speaking of Frankie Valli still doing shows, Bobby Vinton is also still doing shows. He's getting up there in years as well. I used to take care of his swimming pool here in Southwest Florida. He's a super nice guy. Shorty's Pool Service. How old is Bobby Vinton? He's got to be up
there.
I have
no idea. 90 years old. There's 90 years old still performing.
Travis with the stretch of the day. We were talking about today being National Paranormal Day and talking about clairvoyance and people who can use ESP to find dead bodies.
Yes.
And Travis said, what if they lead you to the body because they put the body there? I think you and I agree that's a really long game to play.
Yes. Kill somebody, become a clairvoyant, wait for 30 years until it's a cold case. Then they call on you because you've spent your life becoming an expert. And then find the body you hid.
You solve your own murder or your own
crime? That's a movie.
Talking about the Kentucky Derby a lot this morning.
Yes.
Cheryl said, I'm with Jean. The mint julep is not very good. She had one with her son when they did a tour at the track.
I didn't love it.
The week before the Derby a couple of years ago. Not worth all the hype.
I didn't love it.
And what is, you said it's bourbon and what else?
Mint. I don't know. I guess I don't know exactly what else is in it. But it's bourbon and mint, obviously. It's simple syrup, mint. That's it.
So bourbon, simple syrup, and mint.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Ann wanted to hear that hailstorm earlier, sent in a picture of the dogs, and I said that the old guy with the gray face, so cute, she said Onyx is a 16-year-old mixed-breed rescue. Aw.
So cute.
Thank you very much for all the correspondence. Good to hear from you guys. Have a great weekend. We will talk to you on Monday.